Father, we thank you for this opportunity that you've given us. And Lord, let us be like Jericho, God, that we would walk and walls would fall down. Walls, God, Lord, of fear, pain, abuse. Walls, God, that have held up against your people. And I pray right now that people would recognize us and walk with us and understand what we represent. That, Lord, that you are with us, that you will guide us, that you will direct us and take us to the place safely. That every person that sees this walk will recognize that we stand for something righteous, God. And I pray your blessing upon each one that's come, that you help them to be visible before the public. And Lord, that you bless them, God, that we get there safely, God. We thank you for this opportunity. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen.
Domestic violence is healable, and domestic violence is preventable. Domestic violence victims are not broken. Domestic violence victims are not deserving of judgment, stigma, or punishment. Desert Sanctuary works every day to provide a place of peace, encouragement, guidance, acceptance, and healing. We hope to create a society exactly like that. A place of temporary refuge, hope. Leaving an abusive relationship is not easy. In fact, October 3rd, Blue Shield released their newest study. And their study says 58% of Californians are affected by domestic violence. Their victims, their people who would do harm, or their close family and friends affected by domestic violence. That would mean that more than every other one of us has been affected by domestic violence. But I kind of think that percentage is a little higher here because we're all impacted by domestic violence.
You know, I'm humbled when I come to these events. Last year, I know we had the privilege of sitting and talking to the experiences of three different victims who related their stories, and I still recall how poignant it was that they related. I talked to Peggy last night, and when I come out to these events, there's two things that I focus on when I'm asked to give a speech. Number one, I'm humbled to be here. Number two, I want to know the theme, brilliant, not broken. I'll talk a little bit about that at the end. But I always want to research the mission and value statement of the organization that we're here to support. And obviously, that's Desert Sanctuary. But those of you who are community members who aren't associated with either law enforcement or a nonprofit or a district attorney's office, for you to come out here and to spend your Saturday evening on a lovely desert night to support Peggy, Desert Sanctuary, and to have in your hearts the concern you have for domestic violence victims. And she gave me a tour of the facility. And you talk about brilliant. If you want to hit the theme of what's brilliant and not broken, look at this facility and how well they use every inch of it to maximize the services that they give to domestic violence victims. I don't think you'll see a finer property. If you've never had the opportunity to tour this building, there is not a single inch that is not devoted and cared for and kept in such a way that shows the type of love that Peggy and her staff show just in this building. This here, for me, this is sacred ground. And this is a place that's brilliant and will never be broken because of what you guys have done. And I'm talking about myself, by the way. I'm not calling Peggy an old dog. She could kick my butt. I'll never come back in here. That's not the person I want mad at me either. But you know what I'm saying, right? We have to be open to, unfortunately, generations that will change and that have different love languages and need to be counseled in a different way. And I really respect the fact that that's on your mission statement, Peggy, that you're open to change, because that's hard for all of us to do but it's a necessary component so that these young people can usher forward new ways and creative ways to reduce those numbers of domestic violence. And finally, the last one is unity. You will not find anywhere in any other gathering, whether it's last night at Victorville when we were at City Hall, or to here, to talk about unity. One of the things I was struck about the most last year was the first time I had come out for the walk, first one we'd had because of COVID. And so we walked down from the courthouse down here, and I bet I chatted with...
When you try your best, but you don't succeed.
And the quarter mile that it took to walk from the courthouse down here, I felt like I'd known those folks.
When you get what you want, but not what you need.
When you're united in a common goal.
When you feel so tired, but you just can't sleep. Stuck in reverse. Tears come streaming down your face. When you lose something you can't replace. When you love someone but it goes to waste. Could it be worse? Lights will guide you home and ignite your hopes, and I will try to fix you.
To fix you.